Once upon a time, there lived a little elf named Carlisle, who dreamed of having six-pack abs. And one day, while playing in the forest, he happened across a magic statue with fierce abdominals, who told him about the vegan diet. Little Carlisle ran all the way home and daydreamed about a special place not far from the enchanted forest where he lived, a very special place called Veganland. Soon the little elf Carlisle discovered that some of the kooky elves in Veganland were animal rights extremists. All of a sudden, a light bulb went on above Carlisle's purple head. He packed his little elf sack full of his favorite action figures and started on down the road for Vegan Land. After he arrived, little Carlisle changed his name to the Vegan Cheese Eater. Not long after that, he was steady uploading videos of himself in his Victoria's Secret's underoos. But it wasn't all buttocks and cream for our little friend. You see, he brought more than just his toys with him to Veganland. He also brought with him his secret bad habits. The biggest of which was eating too much prickly popcorn from the enchanted forest. One fine day, Cheese Eater took a trip to the Elftuary, where other prickly poppers like himself congregated and traded war stories about stealing TVs and giving blowberries in exchange for the magical prickly corn. Then came the happy day when the non-vegan Cheese Eater returned to Vegan Land. All the new ideas in his head from his stay at the Elftuary made him feel like a bad elf. He sat in a bubble bath and painted his toenails red, anticipating a big night out on the town in the enchanted forest. Later, while frolicking in a field of wild prickly corn, the vegan Cheese Eater got bit on the bum by the warlock Itzy. His purple hair turned a deep royal blue as Itzy climbed onto his back and rode him all the way to Vegan Land, where they searched up and down for emerald flakes that little Carlisle could exchange for the sweet prickly corn. The warlock Itzy stashed his emerald flakes in the mattress and always maintained that he was in fact a elf with very few green flakes to spare. Itzy and Carlisle gazed upon the most glorious mound of emerald in all of Vegan Land. This mountain of Irish moss was guarded by the fire-breathing dragon Rudy and his lady elf Fifi in their flying chariots of steel. Itzy would go on to unearth an ancient curse he dug up from a dusty spellbook he procured many moons ago with his bar mitzvah money. He assured his little sidekick that his curse would chase that pesky dragon and his lady friend far from Vegan Land and the shiny emerald hill they desperately dreamed of sitting upon. Not long after that, the wiry dragon Rudy told some flying chariot riders that the warlock wizard was, after all, a dirty elf. Itzy did not waste any time collecting bits of emerald, following the advice of his lawyer elf back in New York. His sidekick was so aroused by the thought of a flowing river of emerald flakes that he would surely exchange for his beloved prickly corn. After collecting 6,000 green flakes from the village idiots of Veganland, Itzy the Wizard posted 20 thumbnails in a row featuring his smirking face. Meanwhile, Carlisle was very busy reinventing himself as an investigative reporter on his newly gentrified Elftoon channel. Itzy buried his share of emerald flakes in a secret place no Goyim could ever find and bartered the cheapest carpet ride to a mythical land where the comments were no longer disabled. Back in Veganland, our little elf was busy cooking up a batch of noodles with some magic corn for dessert, displaying his abdominals to all the new elves that waddled over to his channel, captivated by the magnetic aroma of fresh poo. On the advice of Itzy's super lawyer elf, the non-vegan cheese eater bottled this sickly scent and peddled his purple concoction all over Elftoon. The iconic yellow font on the label enticed all the little fairweather elves to save up all their specks of emerald and purchase as many little bottles as they could carry home in their little elf sacks. The warlock Itzy dismantled the Dragon Rudy's flying chariot and sold the parts as scrap metal that little Carlisle exchanged for a treasure chest full of the enchanted prickly corn that helped him suppress his appetite so he wouldn't have to eat and could maintain his elf aesthetics. Now all is well in Veganland. All the elves are vlogging what they ate that day and enjoying that soothing distraction that could only be found in a phallic-shaped bottle of little vegan Carlisle's purple drink. So relax and go ahead and sit back, kick your elven feet up, and throw the animals under the bus, because you don't need that kind of burden on your soul to enjoy the benefits of the vegan diet. So grab a soothing, sugary, purple illusion in the penis-shaped can. This presentation has been made possible by the financial support of the following individuals and organizations: Pizza Hut, Coca-Cola, Arby's, the Dairy Farmers of North America, Little Carlisle's brand purple drink and vaping tobacco, and Gory's All Canine Wieners. Have a fantastic day and good night.